Hey you and welcome to my channel. My name is Tina and my aim is to improve your drawings just like others have done for me when I just started out. In today's video, I'll explain how I created this little Tarzan sitting on his gorilla mom, Kala's shoulder. This is a little more cartoony than what I usually draw, but really fun. This way I don't have to focus on all of the details that normally go into my portraits. Let's get this jungle party going. As you can see by now, I've started with the background. I put down a layer of dark green first as a base color. I'll go over this with lighter shades of green to give the indication that there are leaves in the distance, so it gets that jungle feeling. I'll put in some black to give the indication of shadow and depth, then go over this with the highlights again for the leaves and bushes that are in front of the shadows. When this is all blended out with a soft tool, it's time to get started on Tarzan and Kala themselves. I first started on Tarzan's hair by mapping out the contours of his hair with a very dark brown. After that, I'll put down a warm brown in between these lines to give the hair its base color. You see me blend this out with a blending stump to give me some more control over the blending area than what I have using the soft sponges. Then again, I'm going over this with my finger just because, well, it's kinda my thing. And then it's time to start on the skin color of Tarzan. I first use a very light pinkish color and go over that with a light brown. That when these two are blended together, it gives me the skin color that I want to achieve. After that, I'm indicating the lines of his body and a little on his face, being the mouth and the nose. Then we'll just color the rest of his skin. On the left side, you'll see me use a lighter color than what I've used before. This is because it's a highlighted part that is catching some sun, blending it out with that blending stump again to make it smooth skin toned. Going over that with a warmer skin tone just to give him a little more warmth. And then it's time for some refinement. I start by putting in his big bushy eyebrows. His hair could use some refinement as well, so let's put in some strands of hair that are highlighted and some darker strands too for contrast, of course. For creating some shadow on the skin, I'll use a burnt sienna kind of color. This gives it a warm shadow, which looks way better than a cool shadow on the skin. And of course, blending is key. Use this color everywhere there is a shadow cast on his skin, because of the hair, ears, knees, and so on. I'll use the same color to indicate his mouth too. And just fill the inside where you can see a little piece of his tongue with a lighter pink color. Time for that little cloth that Disney uses to keep this movie for all ages. I'll put down a brown color first to give it a base color, then contouring it with a little dark brown pencil to indicate where the cloth folds. Put in some shadows and highlights with a darker and a lighter brown and blend this out with our trusty blending stump. And that's it. He needed some more shadow for my liking, so I just used a dark warm brown for that until I was satisfied with how things look. And then it's time for the eyes. The eyes aren't a big hassle, at least not for the colors. The hassle is in the size of them. You'll need to have a little point on your pencils to get in those little details. I used a very light gray to get in the white of the eye, because as you know, the white of the eyes is never really white. After that, I put down the green color for his iris. And lastly, I'll put in the pupil with black. Because I put this down lastly, I have no trouble with the black contaminating another area as I blend. Then of course, no eye is finished without that reflective light. So just put down a little white dot to indicate light reflection into the eye. Grab that black pencil again and thicken the line above the eye. This is Disney's way of indicating eyelashes. Pretty easy and effective if you ask me. As I put down some little refinements, I want to remind you about that big red button you can click on below this video. It really has some magic packed into it, as it will remind you of my channel. And when you hit that little bell icon, even more magic happens. This little thing will tell you when I upload a new video. Isn't that just crazy? And very convenient for the forgetful people like me out there. So go on, try them out for yourself. Now back to the piece of magic coming to life on my paper. I started with blocking in some base colors for Kala by now. I use a very dark brown for most of her furry parts and a grayish purple for the skin. At the left, you'll see a warmer brown color to indicate that this part is sunlit, which gives it a warm glow. And if you are a regular viewer of this channel, you know what comes next by now. Blend, blend, blend. Blend, blend, blend. Blend that monkey. And for all of you animal lovers out there, a gorilla is not a monkey, I know, but a great ape. Monkey just fitted better into my blending song. time for refining her facial features. I use a dark brown pencil to put in the lines indicating her ear curves, the lines that make up the nose and mouth, as well as contouring the eyes and little wrinkles beneath them. Also, don't forget that little line just below the mouth, this indicates the lip, which is rather big on gorillas. I'm using black next to indicate the edges where the fur meets the skin parts. This gives it a sense of shadow since the fur will be a little higher than the skin, it's only normal that this casts a shadow on there. After that, we'll use a brown pencil to indicate some hairs overlapping Tarzan's face to give Kala that fluffy furry look, and to cover up some of Tarzan's chin since it seemed a little bit too big. Pastel is a great medium, isn't it? Just covered up the mistake I made with his chin and no one will ever know. Except for you, of course. This part isn't so visible on camera, but I'm using a black pencil and a lighter brown afterwards to get in some fur on the face and other furry parts of Kala. This way you see fur all over and not just a base color. You can see it way better here on the highlighted part. I'll go over with a lighter orangey brown for most highlighted hairs, and afterwards I faded out the highlighted area with a darker orangey brown so it fades out smoothly into the darker fur color. And then again, I'll indicate some fur around her chest so that it looks like fur is overlapping there too. Next up are the shadows and highlights on the face. I first start with a very dark brown for the shadows. There aren't as many, so this is just a case of imagining where the light comes from, in this case the top left corner. Accordingly, I'll put the highlights in as well. With a lighter purplish gray color, I'll indicate the parts that stick out and catch some sunlight that way. After that, I'll put in some more shadows on the left of the chest and beneath the stripe where the chest sticks out a little more. And lastly, the eyes. Lots of artists start with the eyes, as do I when I'm painting, but for some reason, when I'm working with pastel, I usually don't. Maybe I just like the zombie look of them before I put in the eyes. Who knows what goes on into my brain. Anyway, back to the eyes. I start with that light gray color first, just like I did with Tarzan's eyes, and color in the white part of the eye. After that, I'll go in with a brown pencil to color in the iris, and last but not least, the pupil, and blend again with the blending stump, and lastly, don't forget the highlights at the end for extra effect. One last critical look at my drawing tells me that I need to make a little bit of adjustments and refinements before I can call this finished. And there you have them, the finished Tarzan and Kala. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I really appreciate your support as this helps to grow my channel and reach other people just like yourself. Hope to see you again next Friday, and in the meantime, have a great week.